Good evening. Let's connect together this stackable connector, an ESP-01 module, a battery, a breadboard and few wires. And our ESP-8266 microcontroller starts to run a blink program and we can make it to drive a high voltage relay for this mains electricity heater. And here, the same ESP-01 module uses an I2C bus for a display. With the help of these example systems, I am today going to show you an easy way for flashing new programs to ESP-01 modules. A NodeMCU development board costs about $2.50. Take one of those. Let's share the common ground between a ground pin of the NodeMCU and a ground pin of our ESP-01 module. Join some 3-way power pin of the NodeMCU to the VCC pin of the ESP-01 module. Join together the RX pin of the NodeMCU to the RX pin of the ESP-01 module. Between the two microcontrollers, join both TX pins together. Next, join both reset pins together. And join together the gpio0 pins as well. Pay attention to that on a NodeMCU, the gpio0 pin is marked as D3. Pull up the chip hold power down pin of the ESP-01 module by connecting it to some 3.3 volt power pin so that the microcontroller of the ESP-01 module would remain active. But do the opposite for the NodeMCU. Here, this EN marking stands for the chip hold power down pin of the NodeMCU. Pull this pin down to the ground so that from this moment on the microcontroller of the NodeMCU won't disturb us. Leave the GPIO2 pin of the ESP-01 module unconnected. Power up the system by connecting your USB cable and then try to upload your first program. Here, I was lucky with this NodeMCU individual and my new, slower blink program started running without any power supply issues. In this case, the NodeMCU lies on a breadboard and is connected to the ESP-01 module with male-to-female DuPont jumper wires. You won't later get mixed up with your wires if you replace their small plastic housings to these bigger ones. If you use some simple breadboard adapter for your ESP-01 module, you can use ordinary male-to-male jumper wires as well, and there on the breadboard your wires won't get mixed up either. Power sources of some of the NodeMCUs are not strong enough for supplying current to two microcontrollers at the same time. You can try to flatten the peaks of current consumption by adding a bypass capacitor between 3.3 volt pin and some ground pin of your system. A 10 microfarad capacitor happened to be suitable for this individual NodeMCU. I didn't test other capacitors. If the adding of a capacitor doesn't help, the problem will be solved if you add this one extra ground wire to your system and use these two wires as ESP-01 module's own separate power source. For uploading programs, it isn't obligatory to have an access to the reset pin. For instance, at this Sonoff TH16 module, we can easily access the VCC, ground, RX, TX and GPIO0 pins. But the reset pin is pulled up with a 10 kilo ohm resistor in such a manner that this pin is difficult for us to reach. In this kind of situations, you can put the microcontroller into the programming mode by keeping the GPIO0 pin pulled down to the ground while powering up the system. Here, it can be easily done by pressing this button. And now we can upload our first program to the Sonoff Wi-Fi socket as we are used to do with ordinary USB to serial converters. And we can, for instance, blink the onboard LED that is here connected to the GPIO 13 pin. After uploading, we could use these TX and RX pins for an E2C bus. But here, I want to use this splendid 2.5mm connector. It already has connections to ground, to 3.3 volt power and to the GPIO 14 pin. And later, we will solder to this place a short piece of wire or a tiny resistor to connect the GPIO 4 to this pin. But here, I just use a paper clip to get access to the GPIO 4 pin because I want first to test our next program that uses the I2C display, an input-output pin expander and a radio module. And we get a system that starts receiving temperature measurement values from this thermometer. I put now the thermometer into a colder environment, into my freezer. And as the measured temperature now drops below 21 degrees Celsius, the program pulls up the GPIO 12 pin that is connected to this red LED and to the mains electricity relay of the Sonoff Wi-Fi socket. This system could already now control mains current and our electric heater if I would connect the high current wires to these connectors. But that is something that we will spare to our next video. See you then! And by the way, that next video will be especially interesting as we are here using an SX1276 chip that people usually use for long-range communication with their Arduino Unos. So, watch our next video if you are interested in this kind of wireless thermometers. Thank you for this evening. Goodbye.